Okay, guys, Max's Models. I'm at Hurricane Hobbies. Place is hopping, as you can tell by all the background noise. Ian just got another lot. This is not a shipment from the company, but a lot that he bought from someone. A lot of Tamiya stuff, so we're going to go over it real quick, because I still have to go back and get ready for tonight. So, we have a one-off from a company called Skybow, which I may have heard of. I don't know if it's somebody else's kit repopped. It's the 1.5-ton personnel carrier. Interesting kit. And still completely in the cello, and we have a still cello wrapped monogram RF-101B Voodoo, the recon version. We have a couple of these little wooden assembly kits. Now, we have two kits from Academy, the tow missile carrying Humvee, and the Warrior MCV, and then we have two kits from the AFV Club. Now, a couple of these kits have been open, but I inventoried them. It looks like they're complete. The M35 truck and the Long Tom cannon. The Long Tom is one of them that's been actually both the AFV kits. The boxes are open, but inventoried to look complete. From Dragon, this is part of their Korean War series. It's interesting because we were just talking about Korean War models. The Chinese Volunteer T-34-85. This one also has been opened, but I inventoried it. It looks complete. The British self-propelled gun. This is, I don't know if the Chieftains covered this or not. I don't think I'm familiar with that particular one. And that's not a Valentine chassis it's on, is it? Well, anyway. Oops, wait a minute. Well, the cello slit, but it's, I put my finger under it here, but it's still complete. It's just that one slit. And I think we've seen one of these before, from a previous video here, but this is a, German half track. I call them the Skavids for short, but I know that's not right. But it's the 253, and, Then we have three Italeri kits, the BMW and the Zundapp. I actually built the Tamiya BMW and Zundapp as a kid, and great kits, unbelievably detailed. But Italeri, I think, cut their own molds, and there's just the BMW R75 by itself. Then we have an M7 Priest, again, a vehicle we talked about recently, and this is also Italeri, although I'd have to do the research and maybe somebody else's. So, just to keep this quick, the rest are all Tamiya. We have another SDKFZ, this is the 232, a Tiger 1 and Abrams, another King Tiger, another Tiger 1, the early version, so there's so many versions of the Tiger. Let's see what else. A couple more half tracks, a Panther, Challenger. Then we have the flat gun, Fork 1. We actually have two of those kits. Another King Tiger, the JS3. If they could have got that thing to work, it would have been a bigger tear. Still a pretty terrifying tank to look at. Then the M3 Bradley. The rest of this is mostly personnel. Army infantry, a 20mm flat gun, a field kitchen. 4 GPA, mortar team, a couple of mortar teams, Panzer Grenadiers, actually quite a few mortar team sets. I guess he was going to do a mortar platoon. U.S. Infantry, Assault Infantry set, European Theater, then the little Stuart Light tank. I always love that little tank. Another anti-aircraft gun, more military miniatures, then a universal carrier, then the Panzerkampfwagen 4 short barrel, the Alps D, and then the M16, my favorite version of the half-track. That's the one that has the quad 50 caliber on it. Anyway, these are all, once they get them priced out, they're all going to go on the shelf at Hurricane Hobbies. All right, guys, live stream tonight. We'll see you later, and as always, model on.